Hi everyone, my name is Stanczak, and in this video in particular, I'm going to show you what the morph transition is and how to use it in PowerPoint. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here on my screen, I have two slides, and I'm going to break it down piece by piece on how exactly I built this and then how the morph transition comes into play with this. So to start, let's first show you guys what the morph transition is and where it's located. So if you go to transitions, you'll see here that there's a bunch of different transitions that you can pick from, and one of them is called morph. Now what morph does is whatever's on your first slide, if it's on the second slide, it's gonna move whatever that object is or design to that location of where the second slide is. So it's kind of morphing them together. I know it's kind of repetitive, but you'll see in this example right here what I mean by that. So in order to see this example in full effect, I'm gonna go into presentation mode. So you'll see on this slide, I just have some random text on the left, some icons, and then some more text right here. And then if I hit the right arrow on my keyboard, you'll see that it changes. The arrow actually went off the screen on the right and came in on this side. These bubbles right here came in from the bottom to the top, and then the like, comment, and subscribe came from the top to the bottom. All right, so I'm gonna show you guys how you can actually build this and how the morph transition makes this whole animation really nice and smooth and actually not that complicated. So to start with this first slide, all I did here was, this is just a bunch of text. So you can go to insert text box, and then you can type whatever you want, type an example here. All right, and then you can also change the color of the text. So for this case, I have this color being more of like a golden type of color, and then this is white, and then a little bit smaller font with it italicized down below, and this is all an Arial font. And then over here, what I have is I just have four circles and then icons inside of each of them. And for this circle, how I did this was I went to insert, shapes, circle, and then hold down shift while clicking, let go. And now in order to get this type of color, all you have to do is if you go to right click, format shape, I picked on gradient fill, and then I also picked this darker navy and then even darker blue here as well. And how I got these colors is what I usually do is I'll use an eyedropper tool. So if you go here to the paint bucket and then the eyedropper tool, you can then pick different colors in the background image. This is what I like to do just so that when you are trying to find what colors would go well with this circle, it matches the same theme as to what your background is. So that is how I got the gradient color for each of these. Also for this, I have a position of 12% for this color and then a position of 65%. And then also linear at angle of 280 degrees for that gradient, if you were wondering. And then I also added a line to this. It's just a white line with a width of 1.5 point. And that is all I added for that circle effect. All right, so you can either get icons from here or you can get it from the nounproject.com. They have a bunch of different icons available to you there as well. And then for this text, again, it's just a couple of text boxes. I have this as a light gray color and a darker navy blue. I also did an eyedropper to get this color. And then I just positioned them to be aligned with this circle for each one of them. So that is how I made this text, these bubbles with the icons, and then this text. And then to get the white box behind it, all I did was insert a shape, square, and then dragged it down like so. In order to get that nice gradient with that white, all you have to do is click on gradient. And then I added in a bunch of these tickers with the color white and then moved them around, and I messed with the transparency. So this first ticker, it has a transparency of 37% and position of 0. Then this next ticker has a position of 19% and transparency at 0. And then this one is a position at 87% with transparency at 0. And then the last one is a position of 99%. And I'll just make it to 100% position with a transparency of 38. So obviously you can play around with these. It doesn't have to be exactly like this, but I just like this look and feel. Makes it look nice and modern and sleek. And then lastly, I just added in these arrows right here. And how I got those was I went to insert, icons, arrow. I picked this one right here. Just click on it and then hit insert. It's going to insert these arrows right here, and then I actually ungrouped it, hit yes, right click, group, ungroup, And if you are wondering how to mess around with icons, I actually do have a video on this, so make sure to check that out. All right, so then I'm going to delete this arrow right here, and then I just enlarged this one a little bit. And then I just messed around with these colors. So this was just full white, and then this one's just a slightly transparent white. So that's how I made the arrow visual. All right, so now that I have this slide all set and done, I then made this slide horizontally aligned. In order to do that, all you have to do is copy these four circles. I'm gonna paste them in here. And so I'm actually gonna make sure each one of these are grouped individually. All right, and then what I did was I just place them however you want. And then if you click on all of them, you can do arrange, align, middle. And then you can also do arrange, align, distribute horizontally. I also covered a video on how to do this. So if you do not know how to do this, make sure to check that out. And then I just hold down Control Shift and drag them to make them a little bigger. So that is how I made those circles align up nice and smoothly like that. So there's two more things that we're missing in this visual: the background image, and then also how we actually make this whole morph transition look nice and smooth and very sleek with transitioning from one slide to the next. So if you just go to unsplash.com, that's how you can get a background image for your slides. And then I just added this nice gradient box in front of it. So here's another trick. If I go into presentation mode and I hit the right arrow, and let me go back. So you'll notice that the image in the background is actually really long horizontally, and it's going from the left side of the image all the way to the right when you go to the next slide. And you might be wondering how it's doing that moving effect from going to the left to the right side of the image. So I'll show you guys how I actually did that. So for stars, you can't do this without the morph transition. You maybe could if you do like a bunch of animations, but really using the morph transition is the easiest way to accomplish this. And if you see here in this image, this is what it looks like. And I made sure to position the image all the way to the left and crop to fill the slide. You don't even have to crop the image for this to work, but just to make it nice and clean, I cropped it anyways. And then if you see here, when I go to this background image, format, crop, you'll see that the image is shifted over a little bit to the left. So what I did was, originally it was like this, but then when I got to slide two, I made sure to shift it a little to the left like this. So that way it shows it's moving from left to right. And in order to shift it perfectly, just hold down shift and then click and drag, and then you can shift it to the left. So remember, whenever you have an object on slide one, and then you also have the same object on slide two but in a different location, the morph transition is going to move that object from point A to point B for you. So in this case, since I have the arrow right here and I eventually want the arrow to come from the left to the right, so what I'm gonna actually do is trick PowerPoint thinking that this arrow is coming in from the left to the right on slide two, but in reality, there's a little arrow right here that I placed, and then it gets a little bigger and comes in from the left to the right here. We'll actually exit the slide on slide two, it exits. But then there's that one that was originally placed over here on slide one that moves over here from left to right. So if you see here, go into presentation mode, this arrow right here, I'm gonna hit the right arrow, disappears, but then that small double arrows that were on the left right there originally on slide one, it grows and gets bigger and ends up on slide two like this. And that's how you can trick it into thinking it's going from the right and then coming in from the left again. And then another thing I did was I wanted these four icons to start from this bottom and then grow up and appear right here. So what I had to do was copied all of these, placed them on the first slide, shrunk them, and then just placed them down here. That way it'll take these icons from the first slide and it'll eventually move them up to right here for slide two. And I can show you what that looks like here. All right, so they're coming from the bottom going upward, and they're getting a little bit bigger. All right, lastly was this text comes down and it also gets a little bigger. So all I did for this was I copied this text right here, pasted it on the first slide, moved it up with the up arrow, and then decreased the size of the text so that way it's getting larger. And if you see here, I have this text that's really small. And then on this slide, it takes that same text, drags it down and enlarges it in the morph transition. So that is how you can achieve a morph transition in PowerPoint and make a nice smooth transition from one slide to the next. There's a bunch of different use cases for how you can use morph transitions. So if you are interested in learning more about that, make sure to give this video a like, and I can put part 2 or part 3 on different designs and ideas I have on how you can utilize the Morph Transition. Also, if you are interested in learning more about PowerPoint, I actually am offering a course on Udemy, so make sure to check out the link in the description below for that. I do have a discount on that course for you guys making it this far in the video. If you did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, let me know in the comments down below if you did find this helpful and what kind of videos you guys are looking for next. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in the next video.